You can't knock LeBron for doing this. He won his championship in Cleveland. He wants to live in L.A. I think that had much to do with this as anything else, living in Los Angeles. I don't think it necessarily right now is about who's got a better team because the Lakers are in a much tougher conference. He figures that somebody's going to join him eventually, whether that's Leonard from the Spurs, DeMarcus Cousins. So he figures eventually they'll get pretty good. I think it really just comes down to the fact that he wanted to be in L.A. I don't think it really has a lot to do with the owner in Cleveland. Everybody knows he doesn't like Dan Gilbert. I think it's just about L.A. I do think it's good and bad for the NBA. First off, the Celtics are as big a brand in the NBA as the Lakers are. Because the Celtics, you know, are the NBA for a lot of basketball fans. But the NBA right now has got some issues east and west because, as you guys just hinted, all the best players and all the best teams are now in the Western Conference. And as we saw last year or the 2 months ago in the final, the NBA was horrendous with ratings. 12 million watch game four, 13 million watch game one. People were tired of seeing sweeps. They all knew that Golden State was going to win that series easy, even with LeBron on that Cleveland team. Now, with another, the best player in the league, switching conferences, nobody is ever going to take the Eastern Conference seriously. Although Boston is getting better and they'd be good next year, they're not on his level. So the have and have not in the NBA is bad right now with conference.
Not to get too far into the weeds on this, should the NBA basically for playoffs throw out the idea that there's an Eastern Conference and a Western Conference and just do the 16 best teams by record?
And I think they should. I think what they're going to do first, though, to experiment in that department, is they're going to reseed for the Final Four. I think you might see that. This year, for instance, you would have had a Golden State-Houston final instead of a Golden State-Houston semifinal. So I could see down the road when you have a Boston-Philly and, say, L.A.-Houston or L.A.-Golden State, whoever that combination is, and the two best records are in the West, I think they will bracket them so they have the chance to get the two best teams in the final. I think they'll do that first before they go out there and do 1 through 16. But listen, you could go either way. Cleveland's dead as a franchise. So, I mean, it's going to be a ghost town in Cleveland. That team is horrendous for a long period of time. So that's a negative for the NBA. The positive is, as you guys have alluded to here, I was watching, I mean, L.A. is a huge market. There's a lot of pizzazz. There's a lot of Hollywood.
On that note, Chris, you know, yes. I was thinking, when you say L.A., he wants to live in L.A., I remember when he went to Miami the first time, right? And he didn't say, I'm going to Miami. He said, I'm going to South Beach.
Good point.
I mean, he clearly wanted to go to a place that was going to be fun.
It was
he could
hot
party.
And sexy.
It was hot and sexy, right? So to say he wants to live in L.A., I totally get it.
I think that's the reason. Remember, he went to South Beach. He took Bosch with him, and Wade was there. So I think that was also about winning a championship. He felt Cleveland couldn't do so. Going to L.A., he doesn't have anybody else with him, and the conference is much tougher. But I don't think LeBron cares. He knows with him on a team, they're going to be pretty good anyway. And he figures along the way, as we said, somebody will join him. Again, Leonard from the Spurs looks like it's going to be that person, and then he can compete. But, so, you know, you saw LeBron in a private plane. He came in from Anguilla this week. We all saw the pictures. He didn't land in Akron. He landed back in Los Angeles. So I think he's into the LA scene.
Let me try this one on you, Chris. I think this is much more about business opportunities than it probably is about basketball opportunities, and that the field of business opportunities in the L.A. area are much greater in entertainment and other ancillary things than they might well be for him in Cleveland. Here's my play. Down the road, what he really wants is to be an owner. And I see him and Magic Johnson getting together and becoming the owners of, if not the Lakers, some other NBA franchise, because they probably have the capital on their own to do it, and if not, to put together a syndicate.
I could definitely see it. Jordan's his buddy. He owns Charlotte. I could see that. Now, listen, LeBron can make $1 billion if he plays on the moon. I mean, he's LeBron James. I don't think he was hurt advertising-wise by being a member of the Cavaliers. He's bigger than sports. He's the biggest athlete we have in America. And he's probably a couple soccer players. He's probably the top five, top 10 athletes in the world right now. So I don't know I don't know how much more money can you make. He's making, what, $75 million a year, $80 million a year? I heard the worth with him. I think it's just lifestyle. I think it's got a lot to do with it. Lou challenge.
Yep.
The one thing I disagree with a lot of basketball people, I think they're nuts by saying, well, if he wins a championship here, that means he wins a championship in three cities, he'd be the all-time greatest. No, he wouldn't.
Yeah.
I like the idea of staying in one city your whole career. Bird, Russell, Jordan, Isaiah. I like that, where you spend 20 years in one city and win multiples, then bouncing around city to city winning championships. So I disagree with that idea.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.